this week on Sailing Catalpa, we install our new batteries and rewire Catalpa. Hope you guys enjoy. Wild and free, maybe we could dream
farther than our eyes have ever seen. We've got so much to do, but our plan's to get going in 3 weeks, so time's ticking. One of the things we had to get done, our batteries are about 4 or 5 years old, and we didn't want to cross the Indian Ocean with batteries that could potentially fail. So we've ordered new batteries. I picked them up yesterday, and we're just going to clean up our whole wiring system once again. I've done it before, but I just want to tidy it up a little bit more. I'm going to give you a look here. So I've actually cut a hole in our floor, which was a diesel tank originally. So there's our three new batteries. So there's 750 amp hours of batteries, which we are replacing from our original bank over here, which was 660 amp hours of battery. And the idea was to move the weight to the center of the boat a bit more and create a little bit more space for provisioning and just to tidy up all of these wires that and connections and terminals, and maybe look at running a few different wires while we're playing with the wires. Alternate a starter motor, make sure we're getting charged, make sure we've got a good connection with the starter motor, and just a general tidy up. A little bit oversized, but we've got some new bus bars in replacement of little bars here, and all the connections hanging off there, doubling up connections on terminals. We're just going to try and pretty much organize it a little bit better. So these are just from our standard wholesaler. How much were they? I think they were like $50. So it's all just tin copper. Pretty much it's a bus bar, 3-4 times cheaper than what you would going through a marine chandlery. So same time, we're trying to budget but do it properly, and that's by far a nice heavy connection, probably overdone. The bus bar size probably only needs to be this big, but over here the price difference, it's so cheap for all these materials here. When we drove into KL from Penang, which is about a 4 hour drive, we came across some really, really scary scenes. Motorbikes, scooters, young kids. They call it ghosting. So they pretty much hold onto their scooter handlebars and sort of lay flat along their seat, and they go as fast as they can, and they trail the tailwinds of all these trucks down the highway that are doing maybe, trucks were sitting on about 120, 130. And we've seen two motorbikes get sucked under, churned up, spat out the back. And we've seen near misses, we've seen bumps, and just to drive amongst it all. Just a little heads up. If you are thinking of hiring a scooter around KL, I wouldn't hire a car. I think it's got the third highest death rate on the roads. So I think it was 18.4 people a day alone die just on motorbikes. And I think the main age was between 16 and 21. So I think Thailand takes that in second, which we've seen a lot of accidents up there. And in previous movies, I think we've also said, if you want to get around safely up there, I'd suggest just hiring a car. After what we've seen in one day here alone, it's just scary. So yeah, heads up on that, but time to get into this wiring. So what I'm actually going to do, this is going to be a new provisioning box. So all these wires here that run down and around and through everywhere, I want to try and redirect these under the floor here where I've cut this out. And I'm going to bring them up here, and I want to get our bus bars mounted maybe on a board at the back there, nice and neat, so I can see. I'm going to label all the cables. I suggest if you do any wiring, you have a look at it 6 months later and you're like, uh-oh, what was that wire? So I'm just going to put a bit of masking tape around and just label everything and try and just get it all into this corner here and just tidy up all this. Another thing we got yesterday, it's probably a bit of overkill. It's 50 millimeters squared cable. It's actually welding cable. Over here, it's just from a welding supply shop. Still 50 millimeters squared. It's set the coating on here. It's double insulated. It's what is it? I think it's 400 amp. So, and just very cheap. I've got to put I'm going to cut this just so I've got the three coming off the battery here, and I'm going to put a shunt in between here and here, and that's how like your little Victron meters measures the amp hours in and amp hours out. And so I'm going to come off here, and the shunt will be between here and here. then.
You nearly got a bite. I'm making him breakfast.
It's
really inconvenient.
Seriously, like, you're leaning over all my circuitry here. How am I meant to get this boat wired up?
Working on your boat and living on it at the same time is pretty much a nightmare. We removed the old batteries and vacuumed out all the crap that had fallen down there over the years.
So my new little bus bar, this is my negative one. I've just built myself a little shunt. I've cut down some more bus bar here. That'll be my three main negatives coming in here, and they go through a shunt, and that will give me my amp hours in and out. And then this is all our new connection, so our new bus bar, everything's got a nice solid fixing to go to. And we'll just tidy things up down here. It's gonna go from sort of like this over here with all these bird's nests of wires over little piddly bus bars that had all these sort of terminals hanging off them to a nice solid one. All right, well that's the start of our bus bar. So obviously we had the before that looked like this, and then now it looks like this. So that's my three positives coming off our new batteries. I've got the three negatives down here, which is connected to the shunt. And then I'm gonna wire the shunt up, which will show me through the monitor exactly what's going in and out of the battery bank. Now I just gotta tidy it all up.
So the boat is a mess. Well, that's terrible lighting. Boat is really messy. We've got no water, no toilet, and not very many lights. So I've actually just booked a place just up here. It's only, it's pretty cheap to stay, so we're gonna go stay there tonight because it is ridiculous on Catalpa. Bella doesn't have a bed, all the stuff is piled on her bed. Yeah, anyway, we're gonna go and have some luxury for the night.
What's going on there, Belly?
I don't know.
You don't know? We're running wires, using some pull cords and redirecting our wires over to our new bus bar. That what you're doing? Yeah, awesome.
Thanks, Bell. Get those ones through first.
So what we're doing is pulling wires through so they go underneath here with all the other wires instead of in here, which is going to be our food storage.
What are you doing there, Belly?
Drilling some holes.
So it's having a bit of fun there.
So have you finished? This is all the wiring done in here?
No.
Want to talk about it?
I like it on the other side of it, yeah. I'm going to lift up the floor and then run all the lines to the alternator and everything. Alright, there's one wall up. So this is going to be our storage locker. We're going to line this, like I said earlier, and I'm just a bit concerned because stuff does fall down underneath the seating area here, so I'd hate something to cross those two and have a fire or something. So I might, at a later date, just got to keep moving, but I'm going to maybe make a little perspex cover just to screen that off so nothing can actually drop down on it. But that's roughly done. So I've done the main bus bar to the house bank with all new lines to the batteries, new lines, new bus bars, a few new bits and pieces and new terminals here and there. I haven't done too much on our start battery at the moment. I will look at that. But at the moment, I'll finish off this locker so we can get some provisioning done. We're getting there. How to rewire your boat in 2 days.
So we just got back and Lee has finished up the storage, the provisioning box. He lined it very nicely. It's all ready for us to provision up. It's pretty much done. I think this bus bar has wired up all the new batteries, lights and fridge and all the things that weren't working, the water pumps, they're all working again. And yeah, he's a bit tired, the old boy.
Yep, I'm done today.
Had some big days. It's pretty much rewired the boat in 2 days. He's done an amazing job, as always. You know, I think he's amazing, guys, but he seriously, he's done a cracker of a job. You know what else has? This little vacuum cleaner. How stoked are we that we have a vacuum cleaner right now?
Amazing.
Lee went and bought one. We haven't had one for 3 years. And the stuff this sucked up, yeah, it was...
It's been emptied about 20 times in the last 2 days. All right, 6 o'clock, I'm done. I sort of don't like playing too much with wires when I'm tired. I had a leftover bus bar, or half a one, from the shunt that I set up over there. So I've cut that in half, and I'm gonna put those on the terminals and just give us a little bit more room with all this hanging off here. Ideally, a couple more bus bars would be good, but that's not gonna happen. But there's stuff like this, these old wires that are like that, and with vibration and whatnot, you can see half of them are all just falling apart. The original lugs have been like flattened out with a hammer, so it's really put a lot of pressure on there, and it's, yeah, it's not the best. It's done its job, but yeah, not recommended. I don't know, they're not crimped really well, but so I'm gonna tidy all this up tomorrow. And this here's got a lot of pressure on it, and that's that goes to the starter motor, so I don't even know under here what that connection likes, but looks like between the lug and the wire. So with that much tension on there, it's probably all split most of those wires, so I'm not gonna have a lot of contact there, which you want for your starter motor. So I'm gonna run that a lot looser with a heavier gauge down to the starter motor, and also one to the alternator, and see how we go tomorrow. Tidy that up and we're done.
Off to Africa!
Oh, I can sleep and Sarah can drive me to Africa.
He's back into it today. Just cleaning up this side of the battery bank.
Yeah.
Where the start battery is.
Yep.
I don't know if we've ever showed you guys, because we're always lazy when we do a walkthrough, but this is our fuel bladder. And that's where it lives. We have one either side. And they're under the bunk beds. They hold 200 litres each. Is that right?
That's correct.
That is correct.
So we've been staying in a hotel the last couple of days because Lee was... pulled the boat apart, rewiring everything, and we thought it was easier. We didn't have to pack up and clean up every night to put our beds back together to stay in a hotel, so that's what we're doing. Anyway, he got food on his way back to the room last night, and he got a dose of food poisoning. He's been spewing his guts up all night. Poor thing, he's exhausted today, so it's kind of set us back another day. We were planning on leaving tomorrow, but we are now probably be another day or two getting ready, which is fine. I'm just walking to the pharmacy to try and get him some hydration stuff, because we're not near the boat, we're 10 minutes away from the boat. But it's been a fun night. Hopefully he feels better. There's nothing worse than being sick and being on the boat and everything's a mess, so yeah, we just booked another night, another aircon, and relax for the day and get into it tomorrow.
One of the hardest things in a boat is I wanted to run some new wires to the windlass, and it's only a few meters of wire to run, but the thing is, on a boat, everything's packed into all compartments everywhere, so to run one wire through, there's more work in emptying out all the lockers and finding a way to run the wire. But at the same time, it's given us a chance. That was our fuel bladder, so just to service everything, re-tighten up all of our connections, have a look around, clean out all the lockers, and start fresh again.
Cull some of this crap that we've got. We got no space.
Yeah, Bella's bedroom is just...
I don't know where Bella's supposed to sleep.
Yeah, she'd probably sleep up there.
Oh, we got a lot to do. Lots to do today, guys.
Busy, busy.
Busy, busy. And this one's just recovering from a dose of food poisoning.
Struggling. I'm struggling.
Oh, he's just lost half his weight.
Yeah. It's been a long night. So I've actually run some heavier duty cables up to the windlass. And I've moved the control box, which was sitting under here. And it used to get a little bit of water. It must dribble through from where the chain comes down. So I thought I'd pull it back over here. And the kids always jam the skateboards up in there, so I didn't really want the wires getting damaged. So yeah, I just moved that over, tidied all that up. All the windlass should be fine. So this was actually a battery we put in at Ambon when we were having trouble with the windlass. We weren't getting enough power, and we only had a thin wire running up one little wire, and it's quite a long run back to the bank, so I've run heavier gauge wires up now and hopefully eliminate this battery, which I just didn't want another problem up there anyway. Run some heavy wires, so the windlass should be fine now. Hammer these lugs, so they haven't been swaged neatly. But the wiring was pretty messy in here, and a lot of them had been rubbing like that, and there was very poor connection, probably only maybe 30-40% of the wire really connecting. So we've done a replaced pretty much everything in here. So I had a spare bus bar, I've just cut that and extended that off our terminal because it was pretty cramped before, and I've just done that for here. Just it's all that got done. Replaced pretty much all the high current, apart from all the high current wires. I've replaced nearly every terminal because they were all really sad, small and not crimped properly. So as you can see down here, I've put the bus bar on and replaced the whole section here. I just got a couple more things. I just want to make sure I secure the battery a bit better, and job done for now anyway. Just below here, there's the batteries that we've replaced. Okay, so we've got 750 amp hours of batteries now. I think we had 660 before, and we removed our old batteries, which was from here, which is now a storage locker, which I was going to paint, but we didn't have time, so I just quickly lined it with some yoga mat. But we've got heaps of food storage now for provisioning, and and now we've got a new battery locker. So these were some of our old leads, and again, you can see how they've been like just hammered down. My concern, I'll probably prove me wrong on this one, but I'll open that up. Okay, see how they're pretty sad looking inside. Some of them, even when I pulled on them, just slid out. So the contact between the copper and your terminal's not good. You're gonna generate heat. So, and that's what I'd say has happened. Yeah, it's all good now though. A couple of years ago when we had trouble in Timor, Legend helped us out majorly with the windlass, and then sent a few goodies through too. He's actually worked in the mines in WA, and he said a bit of mines edition Denso tape. And so what you use Denso for is you generally wrap anything in it that you don't want to rust or corrode. And I was just having a look, cleaning out a compartment below, and where the master stepped here, it's actually got a bit of corrosion going on. So just as a bit of a fix now, I'm just going to clean it up a little bit, and then I'm going to wrap it in Denso. So this is our post, which is obviously a steel post, and the base plate there, it's had a bit of moisture and corrosion going on down there, so I've just Denso'd that up. Now I'm going to tape it up and try and help the problem. Used to do a lot of this Denso at work, and it's just messy stuff. The only one I know that really liked it was this bloke I worked with, his name was T. Anyway,
it's in his usual uncomfortable position working on things.
Yeah. After years with the blues, oh, you know about them ice and love. Alright, that lot's secure. I've put a brace in here. The batteries can't come up, and even though they are leaning downwards, I've still put some blocks to stop anything when we're heeling over, any movement. So they're secured, they're done.
Job done.
Job done.
Put that on, screw it on. Let's get out of here.
Yep. All right, I've just screwed another block down here. I've put another block in the back there. I just didn't trust the strap in rough condition, so it's all blocked in, screwed down, bolted down. Job done. Finished.
Good job, Captain! Let's sail to Africa!
Yep.
If you haven't already and you haven't heard, we have a new channel, Life on the Sea. Go subscribe. Really appreciate that. Thanks. And hope you guys enjoyed. See you next time, guys. Bye.